Welcome back to Bloodstained, Curse of the Moon. Turns out we are not quite done with this game yet. As I've been told, we unlocked Nightmare Mode after completing it the first time. I had assumed it was just Hard Mode, but no, it's actually a different, somewhat different game that picks up from where the, where the game left off, with Zangetsu apparently possessed. And I also understand that there are different endings as well. I didn't realize it at the time, but when we didn't have to recruit our party members, we could refuse them or even kill them. And if he does that, Zangetsu actually can absorb new powers, Mega Man style. And different combinations of that can lead to different endings as well. But for now, we're just gonna go ahead and, we're gonna try out a Nightmare Mode to save Zangetsu, who's fallen into darkness. His allies set out once more. We'll keep going with Veteran. I was doing pretty good before. At Journey's End, Zangetsu protected his allies at the cost of succumbing to the darkness. In order to stop him, his allies venture forth once more. They may have to take their ally's life, but can they still save his soul? So we start off back at the first stage. We have all the other characters except Zangetsu this time. Which I'm fine with sticking with them. Hold on a sec. Having the new allies here can lead us to some different paths as well. I mostly stick with Miriam anyways. After all, she's pretty much plays like yours with the traditional Belmont style. Hi! You're new. Oh my god, we did a lot of damage there. Oh, piss! Well, we're off to a lovely start. Oh, we don't have our bay anymore. That's just great. Hard. there's a heart container! Okay, I kind of didn't want Alfred to get it, but whatever. Jesus. Oh, God. Okay, we're back on familiar ground here. Forgot about that stupid chandelier. Might as well. Did not want to go do the boss with just Alfred. Oh, we're back here. Oh well. Miriam should do this part as I was starting to say before. Oh, there is, there were hearts in the walls. Okay, good, that was just a shortcut. Jump too early again. By the way, I noticed the cult card. It had 4444 written on it, which is supposed to be like a bad omen or something in like Japanese myth. Kind of like the equivalent of the number 13 for us. Flames are staying on the... Oh, God. Well... Okay, he's, he does have new attacks. got some new paths we can take through the levels. Some of which are tougher, but at least we can get... I guess we can get more upgrades by completing them. And then, as we saw, it looks like the bosses have new attacks. I wish that when I pick up a heart, I wish it would just go to whoever needs the health the most. I see that right there. Got this section. Oh, he's out of his, he's out of it. No! Oh, good. God. Why do I not trust them? They do break. And we got one of those stupid bats. Is that bat gonna come back? Okay, we're good. Now we have to do platforming these currents. Oh god, the axe knights. Thank you. More icicles that we're gonna have to dodge. We're not off to a good start. Whoa. You have to swing before it's even on screen. I already looked at some other people do these fights without even, with Zangetsu only, no sub weapons, and without taking damage. And one thing I was looking at was how to dodge those final attacks they do. And in that case, you have to hit it like just as it's coming at you. And your timing has to be exact. Get up there. guys here. Guys, too. Come on, man! An easy final attack to dodge. Okay, so I think I'm gonna cut it here, and next time we'll continue onward.
I'm playing a game!